By Gaurang Shah, head investment analyst at Jujit Financial Services. We're also joined by Richard Jain, technical analyst at Angel Broking. Thanks so much for joining, and good to have you on the show. We have our first caller lined up. Just to get a chart check from you on both these stocks, so what kind of levels should this investor look out for?
Hi, good morning, Niveda. Yes, I think both the stocks, if we see on a monthly chart, then definitely both the stocks have been one of the outperformers in the recent past. L&T Finance Holding recently in this panic in month of Jan, the stock has formed a very strong base in the range of 140 to 150. So I think the downside from here on seems to be very limited. 150 should be held on very strongly. And in case comes around 150, that in fact should be used as a buying opportunity if he has a one-year time horizon. And on the higher side, from a short-term perspective, although we are waiting for a breakout above 180 for momentum to get in, but since he has a one-year point of view, I believe that in next 1 year, the earlier highs of around 210, 215 should again be tested. So he should definitely hold on, and around 150 if he get, then he should look to add further in L&T Finance. Even Mahindra and Mahindra, we have a positive view. We have seen a good consolidation phase of about 1.5-2 years in this stock, and since the month of Feb, the stock has given a breakout post that 1.5 years of consolidation phase. So within the auto space itself, we are expecting this stock to continue its outperformance for next few months now. On the higher side, on the monthly charts, as per the reciprocal retracement theory, the target projections are coming around 1020 to 1040 range. So I believe in next 1 year, he should see targets around 1020 to 1014 Mahindra and Mahindra.
Right, there you go, Mr. Patel. It's a consensus view from both the experts. Hold on to both your investments in an L&T Finance as well as an M&M. Let's get our next caller then. This is Girish, sir. And Richard, let me come to you for a chart check as well, because he's holding on to Gujarat Ambuja Exports, gotten at 52. Are there any attractive levels you see for him to book out from this, and HBL Power Systems as well, because 49 was the buy price for this one?
If we do comparative analysis of both the stocks, then Gujarat Ambuja Export has definitely been one of the outperformers since last 1.5 years. And even at current levels, if you see, whenever the stock has shown an up move, that has been supported by good volumes, and whenever the prices have corrected, the volumes are very low. So I think the downside would be very limited in Gujarat Ambuja Export. 245-250 range would act as a very strong support, and the trend would continue to remain positive till the stock is about 245. So my advice over here would be to continue holding Gujarat Ambuja Export once this time correction is over, along with the broader markets. Whenever the markets resume the uptrend, this stock could again show some good outperformance. HBL Power Systems had relatively been showing a bit underperformance since last two or three months, and also usually since he has asked for the long term query, usually 200 day moving average is one which we analyze for seeing a long term trend. The stock price is trading below its 200 day moving average, so any pullback move towards 56, 57, 55 to 56 would act as a very strong resistance. So my advice here would be to wait for a pullback move around 55, 56, and he should look to exit HBL Power at those levels.
All right, so it's a hold on Gujarat Ambuja Exports, and as for HBL Power Systems, you can book out at about 55 level, according to Ruchit. Here's where we slip into a quick break, but Gaurang, Ruchit, do stay with us. We'll continue to answer queries of all our viewers on the other side. Stay tuned. On the charts, he's concerned about the sort of fall that we've seen from the highs in the last few months. This was a stock that performed rather well last year, but it's come off quite significantly since then. What would you recommend to this investor based on the levels that he should watch out for, and PNB gilts as well, if you have any targets for that?
Yes, if you see BEL, then definitely in 2017 we had seen a good outperformance in this stock, but since January 2018 we had seen a corrective move, and during the correction around 160-170, the fall was supported by very high volumes. I think that is the prime reason why we have seen a good underperformance in this stock in this corrective move. And in the short term, I think this correction would extend up to 117-118, which is where the 200 day moving average on the weekly charts is placed. So as of now, we are anticipating a further correction in the stock up to 117-118. If we see any kind of reversals, then I think those would be the levels where if he wants to add further, then he can look to add in BEL. PNB gilts, we are expecting a consolidation phase in this stock, because if we see after a corrective move on the weekly chart since the month of Feb, the prices have done nothing. And also, as far as volumes are concerned, the volumes are very low in this stock. We have not seen any kind of significant higher volumes in the recent past. So I think it's more of a consolidation phase which would go on. He can place a stop loss below 33 rupees because that's a very strong support on the medium to long term charts. So on PNB gilts, I would recommend him to place a stop loss below 33 rupees. And on the higher side, the higher end of the consolidation is placed around 42. So he can expect a move up to 42, 43 rupees where he can look to exit if he wants.
Alright, there you go, Mr. Kumar. Levels to watch out for on both the PNB gilts as well as a BEL. Let's get our next caller then. This is Shiv calling us from Bangalore. Go ahead, sir. What's your query?
Hello, good morning.
Good morning, sir. Go ahead.
Yeah, I have bought a 500 shares of KPAD at the rate of 230 rupees.
Okay.
Okay, with time horizon of 6 months, should I book the profit now or should I hold currently?
Alright, and you have a second query as well?
And one more, I have a TCS of 3500 of call option for this month expiry. What is the target price one can expect?
Alright, Richard, both queries for you. TCS call option, the strike price is 3500, wants to know a target for the May series. And the other one is KPIT Tech. He's bought it at 230, making money with a 3 to 6 month time horizon. What kind of targets can he look for?
So I'll come on to TCS first. No doubt last one and a half months, the stock has given a very significant up move from the base of 2800. And after rallying from 28 to now 3500, 3550, you know, the momentum readings are now in overbought zone. Usually whenever momentum readings come into overbought zone, the prices either show a time correction or a price correction. The stock either shows a time correction or price correction. Now we are expecting a time correction in this stock. So probably next at least 1 or 2 weeks, we think that the stock should relatively stay sideways in the range of 3400 to 3550. So I'm not expecting any significant up move in this month, at least in next 1 or 2 weeks to come in. So in case if the stock remains sideways in for next couple of weeks also, then the time value for the call option could decrease. So any kind of pullback move towards the resistance of 3550, I would recommend him to exit the call option around those levels. KPIT Cummins, yes, even this stock has participated in the recent up move in the IT pack. As of now, the trend is still strong, so he can continue to hold. The target projections for this stock for next 2 to 3 months are coming around 275 to 280. So as of now, he can hold with a stop loss below 240 for target around 280.
Alright, 280 is the sort of target you can look for on a KPIT Tech. Hope that answered your query, Shiv. Do keep those key levels in mind as well. But with that, we're completely out of time here on Call Btvi, your share. I want to thank both our experts for joining in. As always, Gaurang and Richard, appreciate you sharing your views with all our viewers. To our viewers, do keep calling in. You can write to us as well.